Business rock grass. We are continuing with where we stopped last time. We are starting a new topic called vitiating factors of a contract. After vitiating, we shall look briefly at remedies for the breach of contract. Vitiating factors of a contract. Let us first define what it means, and then we look at these factors. Vitiating factors, these are factors that tend to affect the validity of a contract. They change a valid contract and transform it into null and void. So there are factors which change a valid contract and it becomes null and void. And these factors can take two broad forms. We have mistake of law. The first, maybe I repeat, I've said the vitiating factors are factors that tend to affect the validity of the contract. They change a valid contract and it becomes null and void. And these factors include, number one, mistake. We are still on the topic called the rule of contract. So the first vitiating factor of the contract is mistake. Mistake, by definition, is an erroneous belief about something. A mistake once made, whether of law or fact, changes a valid contract and it becomes null and void. But the mistake we are concerned with in business law mostly is of fact. Because we have two types of mistakes. We have mistake of law and we have mistake of fact. Mistake of law cannot be pleaded as a defense because everyone is presumed to know the law. In law, we say ignorance of the law is not a defense as per the Penal Code Act. Therefore, that's why I'm saying that the mistake we are concerned with, which changes a valid contract into null and void, is a mistake of fact. So mistake of fact is the vitiating factor. And mistake of fact, as far as mistake of fact we are concerned, operative mistake. Mistake renders the contract null and void or ab initio. And ab initio, it means right from the beginning. It is a Latin word, which means right from the beginning. That is where there is an operative mistake. And I've said the position is that the parties are restored to their original position as if the contract was never entered into and the contract is void right from the beginning. So there is a mistake and it is proved beyond reasonable doubt that the contract was entered into by the parties out of mistake and mistake of fact, not mistake of law. Then it renders the whole contract null and void and the parties are restored to their former situation as if they did not enter into that contract. And mistake can further be divided into three forms. The first form is called common mistake. The common mistake is made when or where both parties assume some particular state of affairs, whereas the reality is the other way around. In fact, both parties make exactly the same mistake. Contracts affected by common mistake avoid that common rule, meaning that both parties are mistaken. They assume some particular state of affairs whereby the reality is the other way around, or is the opposite. So that means both parties are mistaken and it renders the contract invalid. Number two, mutual mistake. So the first form of mistake as a vitiating factor is called common mistake. Then we have mutual mistake. Mutual mistake occurs in relation to a particular matter, whereby one party assumes one thing while another party assumes a totally different thing. It means both parties are not shooting in the same goal. So they both misunderstand one another. Where each party is mistaken as the intentions of the other, then there is no consensus at the item in law. That is what we call free consent. And hence there is no contract. Because one party assumes something else different from the other party, it means there is no contract. And this can be illustrated in the case of raffles versus wheelers and members in row, and it already submitted the coursework. In row, when you use statutes, and when you use the right vocabulary, then you earn extra marks. When you use cases, you use statutes, you use the right vocabulary, in row, you are given extra marks. So now, having explained the meaning of mutual mistake, you can back your point with a decided case, which also in law we call it stardesis. And now to back the mutual mistake as explained above, we are using the case. You first state a case, then you explain Raffles versus Willers. Then after stating the case, then you bring the facts of the case and you end with heard. Heard means how court pronounced itself on the case. So it is a case, facts, heard. My case is about Raffles versus which louse. The parties entered into a contract was for the sale of goods, arrival express from Bombay. In fact, there were two ships for the explorers. So I'm on facts. Which sailed from Bombay, one in October, the other in December. The buyer sought the contract related to the ship sailing in December, while the seller sought towards the October ship, and therefore the buyer didn't take delivery when the October ship arrived. Court held that the buyer was liable as there was no contract due to mutual mistake. So these two parties made a mistake, and court held that there was no contract. And I've said mistake renders a contract null and void. So once there is a mistake and it is proven by courts of law beyond reasonable doubt, then it renders the contract null and void. And we have looked at the first form of mistake as mutual, as common mistake. Common mistake is a mistake by both parties. Mutual mistake is where both parties, one party believes in something different from the other party. Then the third form is called the unilateral mistake. Unilateral mistake occurs when just one party is mistaken some aspect of the contract and the other party is presumed to be aware of this mistake, yet even the other party is not aware. Then that is what we call unilateral mistake. One party is mistaken only one aspect of the contract, not the whole aspect. And it is assumed that the other party is aware of this mistake, which is not the case. Therefore, mistake is the first vitiating factor of the contract. Members have already told you the meaning of vitiating factors, which change a valid contract and it becomes null and void. And the first vitiating factor is mistake. Number two is duress as the second vitiating factor. The word duress also means coercion or some kind or someone using intimidation or force. Let me explain it properly. Duress is an illegal threat applied to induce a party to enter a contract, and it makes the contract voidable. It is limited to illegal violence or threats of violence to the person of the contracting party. When we talk of duress,